Hi everyone, it's another Padlet session for you. And in this session, we're going to look at the last Padlet type, which is the timeline Padlet. So hopefully you've already gone to padlet.com, P-A-D-L-E-T.com, and you have an account and you're all ready to go. So I would like to show you a timeline that I made of our own group here. So here's a fairly typical timeline, and this one is the Curriculum Research and Development Group. Our organization has been around for quite a while, and you'll see dates and informational pieces. Later on the right side, there's imagery, and there's even links to websites to give people some context. And again, a very common use of a timeline where you have dates and important features that you want to share. Now, I also use timelines for different things like science projects. So for example, what I've done here is I've actually used the timeline to lay out the growth cycle of different kinds of plants. So I'll lay this out and I'll have students come in and they'll move the different plants around so that they can show me what it is that they know about life cycles. I've also used it in history classes, of course, where people are looking at timelines, different wars, different revolutions, different parts of our economic development. They timeline all of those things out. Interestingly enough, I will also use timelines so that people will show me in design thinking exercises the history of a product they are trying to develop. So bringing some engineering concepts into it, some of the design thinking aspects. So let's go take a look at developing a timeline together. And again, this is going to be the eighth Padlet type. This is a timeline. So I'm going to go ahead and select that. And you'll notice that it lays out just as a regular Padlet does. Here on the right side, we have my radiant Padlet. I'm going to call this my teal Padlet. It's something that I really like the color teal. And so I'm going to change that to teal. And of course, I always, always change this name so that my colleagues and my students can find the URL easily. For the wallpaper, I'm just going to leave it like this for now, but you can go ahead and choose anything you'd like. Now, this color scheme is going to be interesting because as the particular options appear on your screen, it'll either appear with a white or a black background. So I'll change this later for you so you can see, but I'll leave it on here on the white for now. The font type, of course, you can change. Now, posting. Now, here's something that's interesting. Sometimes in timelines, you don't want the person's name shown because you just want it to be a straight up timeline. In this case, for classes, I usually turn it on. For project work teams, I usually turn it off. So it's really up to you what you would like to do there. Comments, I tend not to turn these on for timeline projects. But again, it's up to you. Now for classes, when we're using it for the first time, I actually will turn that on so I can give them comments back on their timelines. And if they're submitting something to me final, then most people will turn it off. Reactions, I do tend to turn on reactions where people can like it or they can give it stars. If it's the first timeline students are doing, I turn on grades. I can give them a grade with comments. But otherwise, I'm going to go ahead and turn on like here. And content filtering, as I've said in past video sessions, if you have a very sensitive topic, you may want to turn on one of these filtering options where you either approve or disapprove something that's being posted, or filter for profanity, sensitive topics, or young children. You might be wanting to provide additional privacy protections for them. So I'm going to go ahead and click next here. And what you'll notice is there's two ways to add here. Here's a little plus sign over here that you can click on, and here's a little plus sign over here you can click on. So I'm going to go ahead and start off by creating a post here. I'm going to click on this plus, and I'm just going to say about teal, and I'm going to add some commentary here that it's a medium blue-green color considered darker than cyan. So I'm just going to give it a start there. Of course, I can always add a picture. And here's some pictures that come right up on the web. I like this one here, so I'll add that one. Now, when this appears here, what you'll notice is now there is a plus sign on both sides of these. so you can start adding to either side of this timeline. Of course, you can click here also, but I'm going to go ahead and click here to create something on this side. Now, when I click there, you'll notice that another box appears. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to write in here in the mid 1917, somewhere along the way, we learned that the word was first used, teal, and the name was from a little freshwater duck. So I'm going to go out to the web again. I'm going to look for, I'm going to look for teal freshwater duck, because I know that's where the picture came from. And here's, I think this is one of them. So that'll appear there also. Now, if I wanted to, what I can do is I have some information on the side here, and I'm going to copy and paste it. And watch what happens when I just click anywhere and I just hit paste. Now, that was something that was in my clipboard and it pasted right in. So now I can go back in and I can edit this. So what we know that is in 1987, teal became popularized because it was included in the 16 colors of the original web colors set. So if I go in here and I go 16 web colors, you'll notice that it actually was part of the original set. So I can keep building here, but I want to draw your attention to here. It created for me an image of what I pasted also, because it wasn't sure if I wanted the text that came in or the picture that came in when I copied it from somewhere else. So I wanted this. So I'm going to go ahead and delete this one and it'll just take it away. But earlier I had mentioned one of the black or white post features. So I'm going to go back in there and let me show you what that looks like. Now, under color scheme in this area, I had it on white, but if I click on black, notice that this over here has turned black. It turned into a darker color scheme. So it's really up to you. White and black are the two options that you can choose from. But I like, I'm going to leave it there as black and just go back out again and continue. So the last thing that we found in my class was the reason why teal really grew in growth in the U.S. in terms of its recognition is because it was used in sports. So in the 1990s was predominantly when it started to happen. So I'm going to go back to the web here and I'm going to say, oops, I always seem to do that. So teal in sports. I'm going to go ahead and click on this because this particular website is interesting. While it's coming in, I'm going to delete the picture image that it made of my post also. So I'll delete that for now. So what if I included it in different orders? That's okay. So if I click on this, I can actually drag it to this side and move this around. So students can do their research and they can move things around, or you can change project timelines if you want to. In this case, I know what order it needs to go in. I'm just going to follow along with the timing there. Now, what I don't like about the timeline, just to be honest with everyone, is that it doesn't export very easily. So if I go here and I try to share it out with someone and I try to save it as an image, you're going to see here in a second that the image doesn't quite save well. So what we saw on screen just now does not look this great. See? Looks funny. Now, if I wanted to go and I save it maybe as a PDF, I thought, well, that would work better, right? So, but here's the PDF. Doesn't look so great, does it? So what I tend to do is I will just go in and I'll use a screen capture tool of some kind, and I'll just copy it and make a screenshot of my output. So, you know, I really like the timeline, even though it has that limitation at the end there, because it really is, for me, a way to interact with people online. And you know, you can move things around and interact with it quite well. So have some fun with it and enjoy.